Hello there everybody, how's it going? I am Voyami of Duel League of Legends Comedy David today, and today I am playing as Brand and support lane. So get ready for a wild time because I haven't played the reworked Brand. Well, I don't know if rework is the right word, the updated Brand. And I've also not played Brand in just in general much, and I've also have not played Brand in support lane very much at all. So pretty much a whole combination of just like, oh dear god help. But how is it? I just need to read his passive. How does this work? 2% of maximum limit in 4 seconds, and empowering his abilities against him, Blaze decks up to 3 times, and Blaze reaches maximum Blaze, okay. So pretty much he does percentage damage now with his burn, so his passive basically seems better, is kind of the impression I'm getting at the very least. I can't really confirm if that's true, but I, you know, it's fine. Looks like we did decent amount of damage to the Skarner and the Lucian, which is nice. And it looks like Lee Sin kind of wants to continue the aggression, so we'll go and place a ward over here and see just what we can do. So we'll throw a poke at the Lucian and continue to see what kind of nonsense we can do. Oh, the Lucian, oh, he's going in. I don't know how this is going to go. Well, oh, there's the first blood. We're continuing our nonsense. Oh, I'm still squishy. I only have Pillar of Flame. Ooh, what is even going on? Oh, there's the Yasuo. Oh, I'm dead. Nope, that Yasuo showed up. Why, how did Yasuo get there? I'm very curious as to how Yasuo actually got there. Because I guess he went all the way around and it actually, like, worked. Which is astounding. But what looked like a good situation for us turned out to not be a very good situation for us. Granted, I mean, Jinx got 2 kills, but the Pantheon got 2 kills. Like, overall, that was awful. Jeez, that entire situation was fine, and then the Yasuo, like, just showed up from the Nether Realm. So, props to Yasuo, I guess, for showing to Yasuo for, like, showing up from the Nether Realm. Kind of wish he didn't, but I think we all kind of realized how bad that was in general after it all went down. So yeah, that's an unfortunate state of affairs, but what are you going to do when they come for you? Something music. Yeah, I don't know. It's fine. We're against Chicken Katatu and KS Queen. He's playing Barb though, so I'm gonna go on and say they're not actually a queen, but that's just you know, my general, you know, if Barb wants to be a queen, he can be a queen. You know, it's his prerogative. He can do what he wants, and I don't think I'm gonna really tell him no because he's Bard. And Bard's a majestic thing. Ah, piercing light, stop doing damage. You're doing too much damage, piercing light, and I really wish you would stop. Ah, jeez, now I'm getting slight pain lag, which means that my pillars are delayed. Not very exciting stuff, not gonna lie, but that's okay. And I don't think we really have a good chance of, like, doing an actual fight against them if I had to take a gander, because Jinx got some kills and some extra items doesn't really mean we are better against their kind of setup. And of course, we're just really squishy in general down here because of the kind of items we ran. Funny enough, I was, like, debating, should I go Exhaust or Ignite? And then I wound up taking Ignite, obviously. And now I'm wondering if I took, if I didn't take Ignite and I took, like, something else, would I have been able to save some of the deaths that Yasuo caused? I don't actually know. But if I did, I assure you it would be a very exciting piece of information. Really? Wait, how'd he proc that? Because he only got the Q and the auto off. How'd that proc Thunderlord? It's supposed to be 3. Huh, I don't know, and I didn't mean to auto that, actually. That's weird. I'm clearly missing something, because I don't think that should have happened the way it did, but I don't actually know, and yep, that is just Jinx's death. There really wasn't anything I could have done about that. I used all my spells on the Bard, and then Jinx just kind of got absolutely destroyed. So I wish there was something I could have done there, but sadly that just wasn't the case. I should probably be really careful about, like, dying here. Hopefully I don't see Skarner suddenly show up from the ether, because that potentially could happen. I don't want all this experience to go to waste though, so we'll try to maybe place a little bit of damages here. We'll throw that there and use our E there, and we're not gonna be able to get that, sadly. Hopefully leveling up my pillar first is actually the right call. I can't say for certain, but I'm gonna hope that that's the case. Oh, my pain volume still needed from the Anivia game. Let's turn that up a wee bit and hope we don't get people spamming stuff again. So yeah, this is kind of what I was afraid of, because taking Knight is pretty much awful if you're not ahead, and we kind of started off the game not being ahead. I should have just gone exhaust. This is why I never pick a knight on supports, because then you wind up being behind, and it's just like, well, I don't really ever have a chance to use this ignite, and it's a pretty big shame, I do say. But game's not over. Lucian maybe 2-0-3 at the 6-minute mark. Well, it's not over. It is never over as long as Rainbow Pony continues to be Rainbow Blicious or something. I'm not actually sure. And it looks like we're having a gank on the Yasuo, which looks like it's going to go well, and it indeed did go well, so that's good information. I like it a great deal. Jinx is getting some nice CS, which is just absolutely fabulous. Oh god, this man has a BF sword. Let's not talk about that Pillar of Flame ever again, because if you know what's good for you, you just won't talk about it. Alright, glad we're all in agreement here. Oh my god, Bar was able to afford his Sight Stone already. Great, wait, I think I could have too, actually, now that I think about it. Because I got Frostbane Boots, which was 500 plus 200-300, I think. Hopefully that's not a horrible mistake, it very well could be. So pretty much my Pillar of Flame's down, we need to be really careful. Graham, we need to be very careful in general now, because Lucian has a flippin' BF sword over us. Also, I just realized they got the dragon over us, and it was the Infernal Drake. Great. So they do even more absurd damage than they did before, which is just absolutely beautiful. Doing some decent damage to the Bard, and Jinx doing a decent trade against the Lucian, which, because, you know, Lucian is actually trying to do the right thing, and he's trying to engage whenever when I'm, like, doing stuff to the Bard, which is good. It's what he should be doing. We'll go ahead and kill this guy real quick. I got the kill, that's fine. They shouldn't be able to finish me off. Okay, that was a bit close. Jinx, let's be a little bit careful here. We'll proc one potion because we would like to stay if at all possible. But I know that Lucian could also kill us really easily. Alright. How's this gonna go? Lee Sin, you need to do Lee Sin things. He's trying to do Lee Sin things, I think, and he succeeded in doing Lee Sin's thing. That's just fabulous. We'll kind of stay here for the experience, and then we'll depart and go get our Sightstone. So we do have Pyroclasm. A lot of people in the mid lane. That's good to know. And I guess we will be a good support and buy the Sightstone. And then we will probably go full AP from this point forward. I mean, that's what I would like to do. I would like to rush Rylai's so I don't die as easily. Plus, Rylai's is just really good on brand because it allows you to actually land stuff like a Q a lot easier because they're slowed from the stuff like the burn, and it's just great. So Leeson's taking a little bit of a risk here by trying to take the blue buff. But it looks like he'll succeed. Bard isn't making any movements to go up there. So yeah, he did indeed get the blue buff, so good on him. And just good on our team in general for still doing all right, considering the, you know, thing that happened earlier. I am awful with these pillars, good grief. But hey, we see we can land a seer on him nice and easy, which will allow us to get a bunch of gold with our passive, and that's, you know, one partial reason why some people seem to like brand support, is because of the nonsense you can do with that. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do a whole lot else there. We'll throw another seer in there. We did land it. Let's just go ahead and... I landed it! I got it! I got the Pyroclasm off before the ending stuff happened. But sadly, Lucian got much movement speed at the end, so I couldn't really finish the job. But hey! We actually got a kill there. Did I get it? I think... Yeah, oh no, Jinx did get it. That's good. Because I do want Jinx to get the kills, if at all possible. Let's land that there. Throw another Seer, and the Flash will make it so he won't die. And the Teleport will immediately be cancelled. That's probably for the best. I know what Pantheon's intentions were, but I don't think they really worked out for him. They probably can dive us, because I don't have mana. I'm just going to say that just because I know that I've looked over things like that in the past, so I don't want Jinx to do the same. But it looks like we will be fine, so I'm going to probably... Oh, wait, no, do we... Nope, we can't really do much about that. Okay. I guess I'll stay in lane with Jinx because I... don't want to miss out on the CS so I get underleveled, because Jinx's ore has a higher level than me. She's also missing some CS, which I'm not too happy about, to be honest with you. But that's okay. Let's just, that was close, and that was also a very, very nearly hit the zap, but sadly did miss it at the end of the day. Throw some Seers out there. I guess we'll hold the lane while the Jinx goes off and does her thing. Nothing I can really do to stop that. Oh gosh, this man is a sweeper. Now I'm thinking, like, I need to stay here if I'm going to have a chance to not have the turret die. So let's just go ahead and try our best to accomplish that task. We can auto these the best we can. I got stunned there, and he will be proccing the Thunderlords. Can I do some pillars there? No, because I actually meant to cancel and walk away before I could cast it, but I cast it anyway. Now it's pretty much the end of that, so yeah. Five. Just gonna... Actually, I should probably go ward it. Hopefully they don't have an ability to, like, flash over and kill me, so we'll try to do that real quick. Which one is this? Cloud Drake. Which one? That's the Moon Speed one. So not exactly a super useful one, but still good to know that's there regardless. Go back and try to get ready for our spooky Frostwing's Drain, because you cannot beat the power of the ghosts. The ghosts are the best, and if you don't like the ghosts, then I'm sorry. I feel like Jarvan is in a lot of trouble here, and there is the Skarner ultimate that was very much expected, so he probably should have just, because it was pretty obvious that was going to happen, he had no way of getting out, so he probably just should have just gone all in on, like, the, you know, the Yasuo, whoever was up there, to maybe get a kill, because there's no way a chance to escape. It's one of the situations where you might as well try to fight, because you know you're just dead. You are just completely dead, but that's just my thoughts on the situation. At least did that pillar hit him? I don't... It actually did. That's pretty good to know. We'll try to pyroclasm. Alright, that was it. I'm really close to dead. I can't help you, Jinx. I don't know if I can help you, Jinx. It was way too risky for me to walk forward. Maybe I could have, like, done some crazy flash EQ play prior to leaving, but I really didn't want to make a buffoon of myself and just die, so that's why I did what I did. I do kind of wish I played hero, because it might have actually worked, because you're so focused on the Jinx, but at the same time, like, pretty confident one singular auto attack would have killed me, so hard to really make the call. Looks like crazy stuff's happening over in the Rift Herald area. So far, it's looking like it is not going exceptionally well for us. I'll try to show up, but I don't know if there's a whole lot I'm going to be able to do, but we'll try to show up regardless and maybe see if we can do something. I can't say for certain. Apparently, Scar is going Runic Echoes as well, even though they nerfed it. So I'm still seeing some tank junglers go it, which is pretty interesting to say the least. There is a Bard over here, so hopefully he does not try to do any super shifty Bard things. He's really same with that sweeper. I should probably get a sweeper as well, so he understands the horrors of the sweep nation that I am going through. So, oh yeah, I think they made it so teleporting to turrets doesn't reduce the cooldown anymore. So I can't get angry at people for teleporting to minions right, like, near the turret anymore. Because that happens so often, where people would be perfectly fine, and yet they would just do that nonsense anyway. So I guess we can... Actually, Jinx doesn't really need help at this point, so we'll just let her get the full experience from that, because I trust this Jinx more than I trust myself. I have an okay score, though, 114. Like, I'm not necessarily doing bad. I'm just worried, because I'm a squishy man. I'm a very squishy man, and it's hard to do a whole lot when you're a squishy man like me. Squishy Burning Man, to say the least. Burning Man is the name of some CD, I believe. I could be wrong, though. That could be entirely made up, and I would hate to be lying in a situation like this, you know? Okay, just in case, you know, Lucian was weighing there and for some epic plans of ganking. And that's not what his plan of action was, but if it was, it would have been pretty wild. So I'm guessing you want to level up your... okay, well, that's not very ideal. We're trying to do as much damage as we can, and it will be successful. We will not be able to do much else there. Yes, I did see the Pantheon. I will halt my engagement as much as I want to continue. And I'm thinking I might need to go, like, Rod of Ages or something, because my mana problems are very, very apparent. Which I know Frost Queen's Chain helps a little bit with that, but, like, I'm starting to think maybe I'll need to go Merle-Namakon. Because that Merle-Namakon just straight up gets mana now, which did it do that before? I don't think it did that before. I think they changed it. Because I'm pretty confident it just gave mana regeneration, but I can't say for certain. Okay, let's use our spells to hopefully get some of these. I'm gonna have to use like all my mana to do so, and it still didn't do enough to get that minion. Oh, that's pretty saddening. Oh well, we'll go get our Frostwind's Chain. Lucian shouldn't be able to push the turn and do too much to it by the time I get back. And we'll wait a little bit and grab one more Amplifying Tome. And I think we're gonna go Merle-Namakon because good grief, I run out of mana really quickly. After that, we'll go Rhyolize Grand. Considering I'm support, it's gonna be a long time before I can acquire more than one core item. But we'll see. We will see. Took a nice swig of my water there. H2O, pretty sweet. I'm pretty happy about it. Sizmazda seems pretty happy about it as well, unless he isn't, which is quite possible. Quite possible indeed. Def, I don't know why I bothered putting that down. There was no chance of it hitting, but that's okay. Does you have lifesteal? She has Doran's Blade. That's it, alright. So I can't expect a whole lot in that department, but that's fine. I believe this jokester just... Did he put a pink ward here? He did not put a pink ward there. He just scanned it as he's been doing. He's been slaying quite a lot of my wards at this point. And, okay, well... This is bad. I'm just gonna flash to play it safe. There was... Again, that was a situation where I just couldn't really do much of anything as much as I wish there was. And, I'm stunned! I'm stunned. I would love to help you. Okay. I didn't get the stun off. Nope, that still went off. I am so dead. Am I the only one who... Alright, well, you could have just left, but instead you just had to go in and die. Well, Nishin got a bunch of kills from that. Jeez, what did we do wrong? What did we do to deserve the two-man ganks? I don't think we did much wrong. I feel like we're getting a bit bullied down here, and I'm not very happy about it. Alright, so obviously that was not very ideal, but there wasn't a whole lot. It's hard. Obviously, I know why it worked, but I call kind of like BS on the fact that Yasuo was able to use his ultimate even though he was stunned, but just because I was still locked up, he was able to use it. I feel like that shouldn't be a thing. And I know mechanically it makes sense because I'm probably te technically still in the air, but I was like an inch above the ground, and he got stunned mid through it. That seemed a bit silly. That seemed a bit silly. But as you can see, I've used my Ignite like 0 times because I've still yet to have a useful time to use it, which is upsetting. This is again, this is why I normally just go exhaust, but lesson learned, basically. Place a ward right there. Okay, well, that's bad because that's another Infernal Dragon that we really don't want them to get. So we should probably maybe do our job to try to stop them. I don't know if we'll succeed. How am I over here? Oh, I went through the Bard Polar by accident. That's just incredible. I went through a Bard Polar by accident. I don't think you can get something a mistake more silly than that. That's just beautiful. Jason is doing a very good job at just slaying everyone, though. I don't know if he's gonna succeed in the Yasuo, though. I feel like that was a bit of a silly move. I don't know why he walked just walking in front of him when he was clearly a lot stronger. WTF damage. Yeah, I mean, he's a level 12 Yasuo. It shouldn't really matter if he has, like, kills or not. But that's just my opinion. Alright, so... That death was entirely my fault. I literally just... There was so much going on, and the blue kind of blended in with the water to some extent. It's one of those things where if you're watching, you're like, wow, you're an idiot for doing that. But when you're playing, I mean, that's like YouTube in general. It's like, since I'm watching and I'm much, can be much more observant of things, but since I'm not commentating and playing at the same time, I think you're a stupid person. It's like, well, you know, you probably have no idea. You probably have never, like, commentated and played games yourself, if that's the mindset you're having. And it looks like we're seeing an immense dive on the mid lane. And now Yasuo is also fed. So this game is very quickly starting to go from, you know, okay to just not good at all. But, you know, what are you gonna do when they come for you? I can't do much here. I can't do much here. I just want to not be stunned anymore. And, yeah, Pyroclasm. This is, I hate support. You're just so squishy and you die from anything ever. I hate support. Oh, I just realized Ryze is 1, 5, and 3. So that's a piece of information that I wasn't aware of. Jarvan will get a nice and easy kill there, so at least there's that. The game's by no means, like, entirely won for them. But if there's one thing I've learned from just League experience as a whole, it can be really hard when the Lee Sin is, like, the main person doing stuff. Stack, Armor, Jarvan. They are indeed all AD. But the problem is a lot of people, once they start building damage, are like, I don't care what their team composition is. I'm gonna keep building damage regardless. So hopefully once he finishes his Black Cleaver, which I'm assuming that is, he will indeed go full armor, because they are indeed, like, mostly all AD. Oh god, they're all, like, so strong, though. I die from any of them so quickly. Which is why I wanna maybe go Rylai's and stuff, so I can kind of prevent them killing me as easily. We do have we do have Jinx, who is a much stronger AD carry in the later game. I don't know if that necessarily means a whole lot, but it's noteworthy, I suppose. We'll go place a ward over in their jungle area, try to get a little more vision at our disposal. And we can also destroy this little crystal spire while we're at it. Looks like the Rock Drake is next. It's a bit disappointing. Yeah, no, this is great. No, this is just fabulous. Yeah, no, that just their entire team's just gonna suddenly show up from one bush. That was really easy to predict. Oh no. Oh no, why would you go in on that? Everyone was obviously screwed, and he went in on the Q. Like, what? I don't understand why you would do that. All right, I don't know if that was me being unobservant and missing something, but their entire team showed up from one bush, which I can't imagine any scenario why their entire team would be there. Like, that was just a situation where I don't see how anyone could predict it. That was pretty much just in the worst spot possible when they showed up, so that was my horrible demise, essentially. Is there anything else we can accomplish over here? Not really. We'll just try to do our best to not die, which is, you know, something I haven't been having a huge amount of success at this game, but that's fine. Hello to the Skarner. We can't really catch them, but apparently Leeson wants me to try, so we'll try. And that was a nice stun. I appreciate the effort. We'll just throw everything against this guy, and the Ignite should finish the job. They didn't. They actually had 3 health left, but still good to know that we assisted in some respects. And that will indeed be some more fabulous kills. So that's a good double kill. And apparently Yasuo died as well, so that's good to know. We'll maybe kind of walk over in this general direction and see if we can help. Oh, unless, okay, there's a teleport. Where is that? I don't know. We should probably try to stop this man from dying, though. And all right, we killed the Bard. And I don't. Okay, we're not gonna die from the Pantheon. I didn't think I had a chance of saving the Jarvan, which is why I just chose to do that instead. Maybe I made a mistake. I'm not sure. If I did make a mistake, I apologize. Zap, but he will sidestep it. That's fine. Well, it's not necessarily fine, but it's what happened. I'm sorry. It's just the way things are. I'm trying to think if there's anything I can do to maybe give us a better chance of, you know, winning, but this is just, they have a really hard, just difficult to deal with team composition in general. So I'm not sure. But we're gonna try our best to actually, let's just power cosm before we die horribly, since it's inevitably gonna happen. Apparently our power cosm didn't actually do much, even though it looked like it did. Oh, alright. Jarvan trying to do things. Can Leeson escape? He can, and would have gotten the kill if that crazy flash didn't happen. What's that? That's like 3 for 4. Yeah, he should probably just accept the fact that nothing else is gonna happen. Kill him. I don't think he can. He's a. Oh yeah, he has swiftness boots apparently. He looks like he's going really slow considering he has swiftness boots. Okay, well, I'm gonna go Venusaur large rod. I desperately need to go Rylai's to maybe have some more utility available for slowing them and just helping my team in general. I have 6 deaths, which is inevitably, of course, not good, but I mean, it's pretty much our team in general has around that amount, but still disappointing my amount of deaths in general. And we're probably gonna see a dead rise here because he doesn't really have an ideal method to escape. But he hasn't, we haven't, you know, we don't know for sure yet. I'm so paranoid now about just like people showing up from the bush. I don't know what that green line of the ether was, but I'm guessing now some glitch with my ghost. And they're inevitably gonna try to get this mountain drake. At least it's not another infernal drake, but still bad regardless. And that's all that really matters here. Looks like he, oh no, oh no. Alright, we got the stun off. There's the pyroclasm doing some good damage. Is it enough though? I think so. It bounced the full amount of time, so I'm assuming that what many means we have a six we had success. I'm not sure. Hard to be sure about these sort of things. We'll throw our seer in his general direction and let's just see how this goes. I don't have my stun up. Now it's up. Okay, good. And we will acquire the mountain drake, so even though we haven't been attacking structures yet, that will give us a better chance to attack them. And I'll just help this man do his damage there. That's just fabulous. So wait, you need to have 3 stacks before it becomes unstable. Dang, it's in 2 seconds. Okay. It's one of those passes where it doesn't really, it's not really something you need to consider because at the end of the day, you want to land a bunch of spells on someone anyway. At least that's my take on it. I've just realized I didn't really have a point to go back there because I could still use like a little bit more gold for sorcerer shoes. So that's what we're gonna try to do here. Very good. The 50 gold there is all that I needed. And now we'll go back and actually let's go a little bit farther behind. Let's go a little farther back. Feeling a little bit worried. Leeson looks like he's in a little bit of an issue here. I don't know if we're gonna be able to help him, but we're gonna try. And there's the pyroclasm once again. This is throw an ignite on someone and the pillar, and that worked out really well for us, so that's good to know. Oh, there's the Pantheon. Jinx is fighting the Yas or the this Jokester, and she has red buff and is also just really strong in general, so he should be fine. We'll use the ghost to slow this Jokester, which should be enough, and it indeed will be enough. So that will be the kill. Okay, apparently Leeson had enough to where he can crit him. So Leeson, basically, why did you walk forward in the first place? That's my take on it. Can we really do Baron? I was thinking we should just get the mid lane, but Jinx is Jinx, so we should be able to do this, especially if Jarvan shows up. That'll help us a lot. We'll try to tank this a little bit, maybe. Okay, yeah, never mind. We just like decimated the Baron. Jinx is pretty strong champion in general. We're very quickly starting to see some sort of comeback here. I don't know entirely. We were just able to get Rise because we got like 2 kills there. Our strength is very, our pyroclasms are helping a lot. They should help a lot more now that I have this Rylai's, I would assume. Next, we're gonna try to go Liandry's. I don't know, I could have got like Lunes as well, or it, heck, even Zhonya's. So I don't die as easily, and if I do get caught. But I should really get level 2 boots next. Like that's like kind of the priority I have here. So we're gonna try to do that. That's our goal. Let's also ward around us just so we don't have to worry about dying horribly. And Leeson actually did do the smart move and kind of go more of a tanky build because of all the armor they have. Jarvan went for Black Cleaver and then he went for Sunfire. And I'm assuming he's gonna go for Randuin's next, so pretty relatively standard stuff. And Sunfire makes sense considering how close he's gonna be to people all the time. And of course, Pantheon is going full damage. And Pantheon full damage has real big scaling problems, so we should be good. This Lee Sin is really good at catching people out. I know he may, I kind of criticize him for like going in randomly that one time, but he's obviously pretty skilled. It's just the champion's mechanics in general, which doesn't really come in part with everything else. So I feel like someone should go stop Pantheon, which Jarvan will do, but too little too late. He's gonna still get the turret this rate, which debatable how I feel about that. We'll try our best to maybe do some stuff there. We did land the slow and the Ryze snare. Will might meet success there, and I'm pretty sure Jarvan can 1v1 the Pantheon. I think. I can't say for certain, of course, but I think that to be the case. And that will be another, ooh, and the stun did go off, so that will result in a kill there. And is there like still stuff going on there? Okay, Jarvan did win. I was gonna say I would hope that Jarvan would win that engagement. I think we can. Okay, there's the wind wall. There's the wind wall. I personally feel like we could have done more here, but now I'm kind of in an awkward position because of everyone has departed, so we're going to have to flash away to have any chance of not dying horribly. We'll just leave. You want me to get the blue, that's fine. I will go maybe acquire... Oh, Lee Sin. Lee Sin, you're doing Lee Sin things, that's fine. You want me to get this blue buff that isn't even here? That's fine, I can do that too. And, oh, it's actually like coming right here. Okay, that's good. That's good. We'll grab that real quick and then watch as Jarvan does some pretty sweet damages to this Skarner, but we're not going to be able to kill him, so we'll just work on slaying this turret instead. And geez, Mountaindrake actually helps like a pretty hefty amount, especially with mages. Like, we are decimating these structures. And needless to say, the Yat, our AD carry who scales a lot more in the late game, and our top laner, probably is helping and just us doing good in general. Plus, I think I scale a lot better than Bard, so don't, what are you doing? What are you doing? Pyroclasm, this deck damage, ignite, and the flash will fail. What is even going on here? I landed some damages, and there's another pillar. Oh, wait. I don't know if this is going to be... Nope. I think my seer actually landed, but because of warlords, we died anyway, which is a shame. All right, we should really go for this, and then we should just go. Now, I don't know if we really need to go Liange. Are they building much magic resistance? They aren't building any magic resistance except for Yasuo. Well, he's building a little bit. I still feel like it's a good call. Plus, I have a decent amount, amount of gold to build Haunting Guys. So we're just gonna build it. We're just gonna build Haunting Guys. It's just a really good item on Brand in general, so I feel comfortable with it. Oh snap! What dragon is it? It's Cloud? Yeah, it's Cloud. So that's just out of combat movement speed again, which still obviously don't want them to get it, but at the end of the day, what are you going to do? I feel, you know, I kind of am proud of our team to some extent because, wait, I'm stupid, aren't I? Yeah, no, these are the drakes we have. What's wrong with me? Yeah, no, we have an Infernal Drake as well. So, I thought we had, I don't know, I don't remember when we got the Infernal one, but that's just my memory being bad. I remember when we got the other two, so. Apologies for me being a dingus. It's in the blood. It's in me. I'm a dingus. Okay. Let's continue on our daily business. Hopefully we can hit level 16 relatively soon so I can maybe do some sweet things to just killing people in general. That's the hope. And yeah, my passive doing some pretty sweet damage there. Like it a great deal. Can we do anything to you? Rise is trying, but it did not mean any success. That is fine. No, don't try that. Don't. Just don't. Okay, just don't. I know you want to, but just don't. Lee Sin wants some help, that's fine. I should really buy the sweeper. I just keep forgetting to. So that's my fault, basically. And, hello. I'm assuming they have this warded if he suddenly departed there. Hello to the Skarner. I'll put another ward here. I will keep placing wards until they don't want me to place wards no more. And I will place another ward here. And this is going to keep happening. You can't stop the wards. All right, the wards will keep happening. So there's another one. And that one they can't actually... apparently it was in the vision of the turret. So there's all my wards gone. I tried to spread our glorious wardom to Kingdom Come or whatever. That sentence made sense, I assure you. But we just not succeed. What is even going on here? I'm not actually sure. We're doing something. I'm just trying to find out what it is. And damage is there. And damage is there. Missed the pillar. That's fine. Throw our seer out. We will miss. And okay, well, they land on the two people who still have health, so it's not that bad. And apparently this man is causing a little bit of trick. Oh, I missed the seer. How foolish of me. How actually foolish of me. Yep, and there's the burn, finishing off the illusion, and we finished positive. How flippin' fabulous. Jeez, as soon as I started getting items, I started being a lot more useful. I guess, I mean, it's kind of the problem of being AP, like, in their support. That was a really good game. That was a really, like, just nice game. The comeback, it was definitely a game that was looking bleak, and then we wound up coming back and winning because we had a good late game. And that's very nice. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, make sure to like, comment, tip, anything fantastic. See, I'll be sure to read it. and subscribe if you haven't already. This is a warm fuzzy feeling in my heart. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.